84. Yeah, I guess I forgot to increase the volume. My bad. Yeah, so I started watching Superstore, and I bet you every single person that even looked into Superstore and B99, Brooklyn 99, would have seen these similarities, but like, I never knew anything about, you know, B99, I knew about B99, but I didn't know about Superstore until now, like nothing about it. Like, I couldn't name the characters, I couldn't tell you anything about them, any of their character traits, but not completely. But there's a lot of overlap between the two. Like, the main character woman is named Amy, and obviously had this like gonna end up together with this guy named Jake or Jonah. So I'm like, okay, so Amy is with Jake / Jonah, and then it started with rivalry in the workplace with betting and with betting with each other and with then turning into like flirting and stuff like that. There's little differences. Like, Amy in Superstore is married and has a kid, but besides that, and you know, but it's still so similar with their dynamic, especially since Jonah and Jake are both like goofballs that are extremely like, get really, I think, into things really quickly. Like, Jonah has, like, he mentioned, like, a gambling problem, and like, he mentions that, and it's very like, he gets really into things. They also both mention like, oh, we can handle teasing, but you know, they can't. And then they're Jewish. Like, they both have like that kind of jokes. And then with like Amy, both Amy's, they're like uptight, they're the roof follower, they try to make a point that they're not, and then they hurt things by doing that. Even when they're like, and this isn't just this particular one, given the fact that this happens in all media in general, but they mention like, even when Amy is with someone else, a very serious relationship, she's like wanting to be with the other person, Jake / Jonah. And then what else? I think there's like that really tough, like very strict, very tough, like woman in, you know, also in it. Like the side characters. And I think there's those kind of side, not exactly, I will give it not exactly, but they're the same kind of the same types of people, not in the same kind of order. Like, the second in charge is not the same as the second in charge in the other. The lieutenant, Jeffers, is not the same as, like, the assistant manager type. They're not the same. But, like, just, especially with Amy and Jonah / Jake. But also, wanted to add, that like with Amy, they're both like Hispanic women, and they kind of have to be the one that calls out a lot of things and has to be the responsible one. I think it probably will continue that with them, because if I am correct, I think I haven't watched much, but with Amy and Jonah, they're probably going to, you know, obviously they're flirting a lot of stuff, but it's going to just be like, boom, they're together now. And that happened with Jake and Amy in B99, where they're like, we're just going to go on a date, and that's it. Nothing more than that. And then they instantly sleep together. I'm guessing it's going to be the same kind of thing. There's also the shameful two other people sleep together kind of thing in both shows, where two of the main crew workers sleep together, and they're like, oh, you guys, like, that's the most unbelievable pairing, whatever. And I don't know. Sorry, one sec. I wonder what kind of shoes those are that Mark wears, and how expensive they are. And I'm not, again, I say I'm not saying it in a rude way. He clearly wears these shoes a lot, but I just want to know. Because it's very funny, because it's probably a $25 shirt from Target. I know for sure that he cut up his own pants, and then expensive shoes is why. And then an Apple Watch. So it's just like a really funny thing to me. Big difference between Superstore and Brooklyn Nine-Nine is that, and not to be like, oh, anti-cop kind of thing. However, anti-cop kind of thing. For some reason, the worst people in B99 are firefighters and defense attorneys. Apparently, though, they're like the worst people ever, and I'm just like, was it a defense attorney? It was somebody, and I'm just like, okay, just like, the cop thing. Like, to be fair, B99 usually has one episode per season that is political. Now, I'm not saying much, because I'm not even done with season two. I'm like one and a half seasons into Superstore. But like, dang, they talk about serious issues, like actual serious issues, frequently. And I'm like, you can do that? I'll be real, I kind of zoned out. I just actually started watching the video. I'm probably gonna keep doing that. Just saying. Also, yeah, with the boxes back there. But, I saw a post and someone was like, is there a way? You'll never need them. And I'm just like, I love how that they're not like put in together, so they look even worse than they are. But just like, I have a family of five, and just like, those are all our boxes since like we started getting Apple products, like Apple phones. Love that for us. We don't need it. Throw them away. Maybe keep the one, your newest one, for a little bit just to be safe, but they're not necessary. I don't know if I'll sleep. Yeah, my arm is still swollen from yesterday's allergy shots. That's a fun fact. Ouch. This is me actually sitting up. I love that for my back. How do I? Oh, huh. Please figure it out. Who thinks this is a better angle? To me, I think this is a better angle. But man, just like, you know, but no. Back straight-ish. Oh. There we go. I'm gonna put up the window thingy. A blank tab. I forgot to put up the blank tab. I scratched my ear and I look irritated. Ooh. Yeah, I think also what's really interesting is that Jonah, as being the person that I personally probably relate most with on his like experiences and stuff and certain things, it's interesting that there are other, like, I wonder if that's like a call out post, but like it's really interesting that the way that he's done versus like B99, it almost seems like one is adhering to, you know, I don't know. I'll get back to you later. I don't know.